first chapter theme one is maintenance and continuity of life. Okay, the first chapter is biodiversity. Okay, in this topic we will learn about the diversity of organism and the classification of organism. Okay, in the classification of organism, we will focus in subtopic classification of animal, and then the classification of plant, and how to construct a dichotomous key. Okay, 1.1, diversity of organism. So look at the picture. Here are the diversity of animal and plants in Malaysia. So we have a lot of plant. We have hibiscus flower, orchid flower, crocodile, orangutan, and many more organisms. Malaysia is very rich with biodiversity. Okay, in this topic, you need to know what is the definition of biodiversity. So the diversity of organism, whether microorganism, animal or plant, is known as biodiversity. So biodiversity exists as a result of the diversity of habitat and climate. So all of the organism is we call that as a biodiversity. So the habitat is the place where the organism live. For example, we have desert, polar region, soil and sea. This is the example of habitat. Okay, what is the importance of biodiversity? So the importance of biodiversity is the first one as sources of food. We get the egg, milk, plants, animal, all the food that we eat is from the biodiversity. And then to balance in nature. So the cycle of nutrient and interaction between organisms create balance in nature. And then as a recreational place. For example, taman negara. And then for medical, for medicine. And then the biodiversity we need for raw material and for industries. Okay, and the last one, biodiversity is very important for our education. So this is the importance of biodiversity. Okay, how to maintain biodiversity? So we can maintain our diversity by resisting exploitation of forest resources. And then we can reducing the pollution, stop over-harvesting, protect habitat, and endangered species. Okay, endangered species, for example, like Malayan tiger, Rafflesia, orangutan, that's all example of endangered species. So we need to take care of the species so that they will not be extinct. Okay, can you understand so far? So far? Can you understand? This is just a simple topic, just introduction. Okay, raise up your hand if you can clear. Or show thumb up. Like this. Good. Okay, good. Okay, so I will continue with 1.2. Okay? All right. So we'll close this slide. We move on 1.2, classification of organism. Okay, so for today's lesson, I will continue until classification of plant. So for today's lesson, I focus on classification of animal. Okay, the two main group of organisms are animals and plants. So the animal can be classified further into smaller group based on their common characteristic and their different characteristic. So we group the animal and plant according to their common and different characteristic. Okay, for animal, we have two categories. There is invertebrate and vertebrate. Okay, what is invertebrate? So more than of 90% of animals are invertebrate. Okay, since invertebrate have no backbones, they are usually small in size. Example of invertebrate are insects such as ant, butterflies, flies and cockroaches. Okay, most of invertebrate are insect because they are small in size, and invertebrate is animal without backbones. Maksudnya dia tak ada tulang belakang. The animals are no backbones. Okay, all insects are invertebrate. Okay, example like spiders, crab, prawn, worms, and snail. Okay, in the invertebrate, we can divide it into two groups, without legs and with legs. This is the characteristic that we group for invertebrate. So, kita tengok without legs. What is the invertebrate without legs? Kita categorize pula into two, we divide it into two. Without segmented bodies, and then with segmented body. Okay, another group is invertebrate with leg. Okay, with leg, we divide into two, invertebrate with three pairs of legs, and then invertebrate with more than three pairs of leg. Okay, we look at what is the invertebrate without leg. So this is the example. This is the example of invertebrate without legs with segmented bodies. We have sponge, a sea anemone, coral, and planaria. Okay, this is example of invertebrate without segmented bodies. Okay, invertebrate with segmented bodies. The example are tapeworm, the earthworm, and the leech. This is example with segmented body. So the body, it have the segment. Contoh ni, you nampak ada bahagian-bahagian dia. Boleh? Eh? Okay, I continue. Okay, another category, invertebrate with legs. Tadi kita bahagikan dua, the three pairs of leg, the invertebrate with three pairs of leg. Okay, this is the example of invertebrate with three pairs of leg. Okay, we have ant, butterfly, and cockroaches. Okay, another group is invertebrate with leg that have more than three pairs of leg. That is invertebrate with more legs. We have centipede, spiders. Spiders is four pairs of leg. So more than three lah kan? So we have, what is that? Horn crab. And then we have prawn, centipede, and scorpion. So this group is more than three pairs of leg. So we group the invertebrate. We group the animal according to the characteristic. So the first one, the characteristic is three pairs of leg. Okay, the second one, the characteristic is more than three pairs of leg. Okay. Yang tadi adalah invertebrate. Invertebrate, the animal without backbones. Now we move on vertebrate. So what is vertebrate? First, you need to know the definition of vertebrate. So vertebrates are animals with a backbones. Backbones, tulang belakang. Macam human, human kita manusia pun ada tulang belakang, backbone. So vertebrates are animal with a backbone. So we will categorize vertebrate into five group. The first one is fish, amphibian, reptiles, birds, and mammals. So semua ada, we have five group of vertebrate. Fish, amphibian, reptiles, birds, and mammals. Okay, in fish, you need to know what is the common characteristic for fish. Why this is group is called fish? Okay, fish are poikilothermic. It covered in hard and slimy scale, have fin and tails, breathe through gills, lay eggs, undergo external fertilization. Okay, poikilothermic is the animal that have body temperature according to environment. So the body temperature changing according to the environment. Dia berdarah sejuk. The definition of poikilothermic is the cold-blooded animal. So the body temperature of this animal will change according to the environment. If the environment is hot, so the temperature of their body temperature is hot. If the body environment is cold, the body temperature is cold. And then another characteristic, covered in hard and slimy scale, have fin and tails, breathe through gills, lay eggs, undergo external fertilization. Okay, example of fish, we have goldfish, we have tilapia, we have piranha, we have tuna. So that are fish. Okay, what is amphibian? So the amphibians are animal with these following characteristic, poikilothermic. So same as the fish. Okay, normally amphibian live on land and in water. Dia macam dua alam. They can live in land and they can live in water. Okay, the amphibian covered with more skin, and then we have young amphibian breathe through gills, and then adult amphibian breathe through using their lung and more skin, and then they produce jelly-like egg without a shell, and it undergo external fertilization. Okay, example of amphibian are frog, toad, a salamander, newts, and Sicilian. Normally, you frog. Kamu boleh hafal lah yang amphibian, frog, toad, and salamander. Ini adalah amphibian. So, you need to know lah what is the characteristic of amphibian. Dia adalah poikilothermic, live on land in water, and then covered with moist skin, and then young amphibian breathe through gills, and then adult amphibian breathe using their lung and moist skin, and then their egg are jelly-like eggs. Then without a shell, no shell, and then the amphibian undergo external fertilization. Okay, next we move on the group reptiles. What is reptile? Okay, reptile are animal with this following characteristic. The reptile are poikilothermic. Sama juga the animal with cold-blooded animal poikilothermic. So it produce egg with a shell, breathe through lung, has scale and hard skin. And then it undergo internal fertilization. So yang ini reptile internal fertilization. Kalau tadi fish and amphibian external fertilization, that mean outside the body. Internal fertilization, that mean inside the body. Okay, this is the example of reptile. We have tortoise, crocodile, snake, a lizard. Example of reptile. And then birds, a group of birds are animal with common characteristic homeothermic. So homeothermic is warm-blooded animal. Warm-blooded animal, that means they have constant body temperature. Suhu badan dia tidak berubah. Kalau tadi poikilothermic, dia berubah mengikut persekitaran. So homeothermic is they have constant body temperature. So characteristic of birds are covered with feathers to maintain the body temperature. So maintain a body temperature is constant. So ini function feathers tadi. Nampak dia ada bulu pelepah. Okay, they have wings that help some bird to fly. And then they have a pair of scaly feet. They undergo internal fertilization. And then they produce egg with hard cell. Dia punya telur ada cengkerang. Kalau tadi amphibian ada jelly-like. They have no shell. For birds, their eggs are with hard shell. So example of birds are duck, birds, chicken. Ni semua adalah birds. Cuba kamu tengok duck covered with feathers. They have wings. So duck is categories, dia adalah birds. And then all type of bird like owl, kingfisher. Ini semua adalah bird. Okay, and then we have the last group, mammal. Mammals are animal with the following common characteristic. Okay, the characteristic are homeothermic. Homeothermic means they have constant body temperature. They have warm-blooded animal. And then it covered with a fur or hair. And then it breathe through lungs and undergo internal fertilization. And then it give birth and nurse their young. Okay, example of mammal. Example of mammal are tiger, elephant, orangutan, bats, dolphin, cat, human. So this group are mammal. Mammal animal that have fur, animal that breathe through lung, undergo internal fertilization, give birth and nurse their young, and homeothermic. So this group is categorized as mammal. Okay, lots of animal. Mammals are like bats, tiger, elephant, orangutan, giraffe. What else? So, you tengok balik lah what is the characteristic. So, kita kena categorisekan that animal, what group? Animal, mammals, reptiles, fish, amphibians or birds. Okay, so far? Can you understand?